In this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to use computers to help calculate integrals that are either difficult to do by hand or impossible to do by hand. And I'm going to start by looking at the example that we looked at in the end of the probability and integration section. It was the function, the bell curve, 1 over sigma. In this case, sigma was, the standard deviation was 100. And mu, the mean, was 500, and it was measuring the distribution of test scores. It was a probability density function. The function is given by 1 over 100 times 2 pi to the negative 0.5 times e to the negative x minus mu, which is 500 squared, divided by 2 times sigma squared, which is 20,000. Press enter. So the nice thing about GeoGebra is once you type in the function, you can always check that your parentheses were actually in the right place, that everything's squared that needs to be squared. The way that I had it written is that this 2 pi was down in the denominator. I entered it like this because I knew I needed it to have a square root as well. So GeoGebra graphs this for us, which in and of itself is something that's helpful, but notice that we can't see what's going on because our view is off. In this case, we're given the hint that mu was 500, so this bell curve is shaped such that the center of the curve is at 500. And we also know that because the total area under the curve is 1, it's a probability density function, so the total probability has to be 1, that the curve is going to be really, really, really flat. Like, you can see that we're down in the hundredths place, but centered at 500. And the cool thing about GeoGebra is that it can compute definite integrals for us pretty easily. So, integral, and I can just select from the drop-down the integral of f, and I want to start at 500, and I'm pressing tab to get from place to place. And I want to end, instead of just a decimal approximation, I can actually type infinity into GeoGebra, and it gives me the solution. And notice if I wanted to find out some other integral. So the solution is telling us that 0.5 or 50% of the students are scoring at a test score of 500 or greater. Let's suppose I wanted to find out how many students were scoring between maybe 600 and 700. I could type in that definite integral and it would calculate, in this case, the area of this region B is 0.14, which means 14% of students were scoring in that range. And of course, remember that under options and rounding, I can add decimal places if I want greater accuracy than 14%. This becomes 13.59% more accurate decimal approximation of this area under the curve. I think GeoGebra is great. One of the things that GeoGebra doesn't do is it doesn't give us closed forms of integrals. So the next thing that I'm going to do is open up Wolfram Alpha. I'm going to copy this function because I don't want to have to type it in again. And then I'm going to go to Wolfram Alpha, which is just wolframalpha.com, and it's a really powerful computational engine. So I can just type this same function in, and if I wanted to integrate this function, I'm going to integrate this. I'm going to say that it's with respect to dx, and it's from x equals 500 to x equals infinity. Unfortunately, I did this previously, Wolfram Alpha thinks a lot, and it gives us a more complicated answer than we would like. Even the numerical approximation, it doesn't give us what we want. Notice that it just retypes the integral, and it doesn't tell us what this integral value is. If I plug in a large number rather than infinity, it doesn't know how to interpret our input, which means that this value is too large for Wolfram Alpha, or it's not willing to compute this. But, so that's the bad news. This is sort of a non-example. But Wolfram Alpha is able to compute many other different types of functions. So let's say that I want to compute something maybe a little more straightforward, like the sine of x squared. This is an example of a function that on your own thinking about how would I integrate the sine of x squared. We can't do a u substitution. We can't do a trig substitution. Really, the only ways to be able to integrate this are through numerical methods. We could do Taylor expansion, actually, is the method that I would end up using. But typing in this syntax, integrating this function from x equals 0 to x equals 1, in this case, Wolfram Alpha does give us a nice decimal approximation. And I think, yeah, they'll even give us a graph of the function, a visual representation of what sine of x squared looks like, an area under the curve. So the bad news was the curve we were interested in for this problem didn't work. The good news is that for many other types of functions, Wolfram Alpha is a really good way to compute them.